Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have got to know that is what is the characteristic of the equilibrium constant, and yes, we have got to derive that is how the equilibrium constant was been derived, and from that what is the value of the Kc, or what is the value of the equilibrium constant that we are talking about. So it is not only a particular constant, but it gives various predictions for the particular reaction. And what are the uses or what are the applications of this equilibrium constant? Let us talk about it. So now let us understand the first application or the first use of the equilibrium constant, and that is to calculate the equilibrium concentration. Yes, suppose if we know the equilibrium constant value, and that is Kc, and in that case suppose we have to calculate the equilibrium concentration of a particular reactant or a particular product. So suppose if we know the concentration of the product C, concentration of D, and at equilibrium we don't know suppose the concentration of A. So this is what we don't know, but we have concentration of B suppose. So in this case every detail is been known to us, and that's the reason, because at equilibrium constant is been maintained, so that's the reason. And we have also got to know that what would be the particular, suppose we know the equilibrium constant for a particular reaction, so that's the reason we could also easily determine that what would be the concentration of a particular reactant or of a particular product. So this is how it is very much helpful in giving the equilibrium concentration for a particular reactant or product, whatever we could say. So now let us move on with the next one, that is it gives us an idea to know about the extent of reaction. So obviously when we are talking about the reaction, and reaction goes in a forward direction, or else the reaction will go in a backward direction when it is a reversible reaction. So how can we determine whether the reaction has been completed or till which extent? So that is what the equilibrium constant helps us out to give the prediction, whether the reaction has been completed or whether the reaction is going in a backward direction or whether the reaction is in equilibrium. So suppose if suppose if we are maintaining the data of what would be the concentration of the reactant or how the process of the reaction is while determining the concentration of the reactant as well as determining the concentration of the product that has been obtained. So suppose in that case if we have got to know the value of Kc, suppose if that is be more than 10^3, so this indicates that the reaction is going in a forward direction, and that's the reason that we could say that the reaction has been completed or is in a verge to complete. But what if we have got the Kc value that is less than 10^-3? So this indicates that the reaction, that is the concentration of the reactant, are very much higher and compared to that of the concentration of the product. So that indicates that the reaction has not been occurring in the favorable direction, and that's the reason that we could say that the reaction is not yet completed. There is no completion of reaction over here. And what if we have got the value between 10^3 and 10^-3? So therefore this is the value in which we could calculate the equilibrium constant or equilibrium concentration for the particular reactant and product, and that gives us a very significant value, and that's the reason that Kc plays a vital role in understanding whether the reaction is being completed or whether the reaction is going on to complete or it is not getting completed. So this is the thing that it gives us an idea about the extent of a particular reaction. So this is what I have mentioned in this one, and let us talk about the another one, that is to predict the direction of the reaction. So Kc value gives us an understanding whether the reaction is going in forward direction or in a backward direction. So before understanding that one, let me give an idea that whenever we are talking about the equilibrium concentration or the equilibrium constant, so therefore we always write it with the notation that is Kc. But every concentration that we are talking about, that is it might be of D or C if I am talking about, so therefore we write it in this way, as you could see over here. But one thing is what we should know, that at equilibrium the concentration of the reactant and the concentration of the product, they both are basically in they are known as equilibrium concentration. So therefore we could write it over here with the subscript EQ, which represents that these are the concentration in terms of the concentration of the reactant or the product when the equilibrium is being reached. And that is the thing that we write in this way. But usually we write when the reaction is being not completed or when the reaction is been going on, so as to convert a reactant into product or product into reactant, suppose, and that has not acquired the equilibrium. So therefore, in that case, basically we denote it by Q, or we denote it by QC. So this is known as chemical quotient, and that's the reason that it indicates that the equilibrium is not being attained till yet. And that's the reason that we could write it in this way, that is C raised to C, D raised to D, as well as A raised to A and B raised to B. So it is very different from that of the equilibrium constant Kc. But what if we have been managed to calculate the value of everything, and that's the reason that suppose we have got to know that the, what is the value of Qc. So suppose in this case, if we have got a comparison between Qc and that of the equilibrium constant Kc. So suppose if we have got a value where the Qc's value is very much less than that of the equilibrium constant Kc. So what we could predict, whether the reaction is in forward direction or in the backward direction. So this is the formula that would help us out. So suppose if the value of Kc is been more and the value of Qc is less. So this value Qc will be less if we say that the product concentration is less and that of the concentration of the reactant is been more. So if the concentration of the reactant has been more and the concentration of these products is less, then we could say that the reaction in which the concentration of the reactant is very much high and the concentration of the product is less. So therefore, we could say that the reaction is moving in a basically forward direction, because obviously we know that if the concentration is more of reactant, obviously the rate of the reaction will move, and that's the reason that the reaction will move forward. So therefore, this gives us an idea that this is for forward reaction, and which implies that the reaction will move on from left to right. So what if we have got to know where QC and comparison to that of KC, and in that case we have got to know that the QC value is more than that of KC. So let us understand this one again. So if value of QC is more than that of the KC, then the value of QC will be more. Suppose if I'm talking in this way, where the concentration of A or B is less and the concentration of the product is been more. So obviously when the concentration of the product is been more and we are talking about an equilibrium, then it indicates that since the concentration is more for the product, and that's the reason that it will be very much favorable for the backward reaction, and that's the reason that we could see that the rate of the backward reaction will be more. And obviously that the equilibrium constant, it depends on the rate of reaction only, because as we have derived in previous lectures also, we have got to know about that. So in this case, we will get to know that this one would be basically backward reaction. And what if we have got to know that is the value of QC is equals to value of KC. So if this has been attained, then we could, that is, if we observe this formula, and suppose if the both the values are been same, then we could say that the overall reaction is in equilibrium. So this is how the these are the uses of the equilibrium constant, and this gives us a very much idea about not only the direction of the reaction or the extent of the reaction, but it also gives us the equilibrium concentration of an unknown reactant or product. So these were the uses of the equilibrium constant. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video and you have understood this concept very clearly, and I hope you will share this video with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.